Coming up next, a new discovery when it comes to breast cancer.
Yeah, one Valley doctor here weighs in on the new study, that what that means for women on this new study.
A new study has made an interesting find when it comes to breast cancer. It turns out that women with bigger chests actually have a higher risk. Dr. Coral Quiet of the Arizona Breast Cancer Specialist is here to tell us more about this study and why the Valley's bigger busted women don't need to worry probably as much as you'd think. Good morning.
Good morning, and thank you for having me.
We're thrilled to have you. So tell us about this study and what it does mean.
Well, it was an interesting study. We've known for a while that there are families that have higher rates of developing breast cancer. Mm-hmm. And we've looked at a couple of genes that we've identified, and these families have been negative for the known mutations, but there's more breast cancers in those families than we'd expect. So what this study did is it started to look at women, to look at other genes that might be inherited that would allow us to determine who's going to have a higher risk for getting breast cancer. And what they found was that women who had larger breasts but were small women, because, you know, there's two ways to have larger breasts. It's
right.
Either you have more breast tissue or you have more fat around the tissue.
So is it the density then?
So density is another factor that we'd look at and say you've got more breast tissue in those breasts. So this study was interesting because it said for women who have larger breasts, more breast tissue, that they're having higher rates of breast cancer. And what they found was that it may relate to the fact that these women either are making more estrogen or they don't break it down as quickly as somebody else. So their body sees more estrogen, so it makes more breast tissue, but also gives them higher rates of getting breast cancer.
Yeah, but higher rate doesn't mean necessarily if you've got a bigger chest that you're going to get breast cancer.
No, not at all. But it does mean that these women are at a, because we know that they're at a somewhat slightly higher risk than normal, and they're harder to image with mammography because they've got more breast tissue. It's denser, it doesn't show up well. So these are women that might benefit from using other modalities like ultrasound or MRI for screening purposes.
Or get checked more often maybe?
Usually, but it's better imaging.
I think it's better, just the way that you check. How about fake breasts? There are a lot of women who have big breasts, but it's not, you know, it's not natural. So because they're maybe smaller women with the bigger breasts, are they at a higher risk?
No, they're not. We've looked at that many times. And implants or artificially acquired larger breasts aren't at higher risk for developing breast cancer. And that's been well documented now and really well researched.
I kind of figured, but that's what comes to mind when we talk about, you know, bigger breasts and smaller women. How about for the women who do have those, does it make it harder to detect something like this?
Well, I think it does because the breast tissue is denser. There's more of it. So these are women that we really do need to make sure they're getting good imaging and maybe using an extra modality like ultrasound.
So doctors are paying close attention to this study. Doctors at, like at your centers.
Yes, I think we've always have been interested in figuring out who's at higher risk and why. And we know that women who have more estrogen are at higher risk, so that we've been I think over time we've done a much better job at watching and screening younger women, particularly that 40 to 50 year old age group.
I was gonna say, what is the current recommendation for when you're supposed to get screened?
Well, it's been, as you know, highly controversial.
Right.
But the American Cancer Society and the breast surgeons groups and my association, ASTRO, are all making the recommendation you start with your baseline study between 35 and 40, and then yearly 40 on up. And that the only exception would be is someone that does have a family history, we want to start at least 10 years younger than the youngest family member.
Wow.
So if you have someone in your family that's had breast cancer at age 35, then we want to start screening them really young, like in their 20s.
Wow.
So those are the women that, but they're in a high risk category and they really do need special attention.
Okay, so what should folks from watching at home take from this study? Obviously, we don't want to worry anyone too much.
Right. I think it tells us that we're starting to finally understand what's causing cancer and how more and more women are, why that we can explain why women are getting it and start to have better tools, hopefully, that will allow us to screen these and identify these higher risk women so that we can follow them in a personalized manner. And I think what we're seeing is more personalized medicine.
Yeah, and what we've learned with cancer, the earlier you can catch it, the better. So.
Absolutely.
All right.
So detection's still the mainstay of diagnosing and getting women in and being identified.
All right. Dr. Coral Quiet, thank you so much for being here with us this morning.
Thank you.
There he is.